This is the last green propane disposable bottle I'll ever buy. I have never liked using these 1 pound propane bottles simply because they are a waste of natural resources. The bottles aren't recycled, they aren't reused, and they end up in landfills. Now, if you camp out maybe once or twice a year, then these bottles would work fine. They'll last, you know, most trips, for a while. But if you're a full-timer or if you do a lot of camping, then you'll go through a lot of these bottles. And they are fairly inexpensive, but they don't last very long, and you end up having to throw them out when they're done. I have seen some people, even some prominent YouTubers, suggest and show how to refill them with a little valve or a little little piece that you can buy online to attach them to a larger tank to refill them. It is, however, risky. The little valve on the top here is not made to be reused over and over, and it does wear out rather quickly. And even on the bottle, it says, you know, that you shouldn't refill it. It's a federal crime to refill it and then transport it. So I really don't want to suggest anybody do that. I know it works for some people. They have used some pliers to pull in that little valve, but I don't think it's safe, so I wouldn't suggest it. And I've been looking around, though, for some way of using something this size, but being able to refill it safely. This is the Flame King 1 pound refillable cylinder and kit. And included in this kit is a base or a stand, which is easy to assemble. It's just this plastic material or base that you attach these feet to. Or I guess they're not really feet, but you attach these two pieces to with these wing nuts. Really easy and simple. Make sure that this part faces the ground. It comes with a tank, a 1 pound refillable propane tank or cylinder that has a lid on it, a little plastic lid. A valve, or this will attach to the propane tank, your larger propane tank. I guess you'd call it a valve or a stem or kind of like a faucet, but it will control the propane as you put it into the tank. An Allen key, which you'll use on the tank, it'll let you know when your tank is full, about 80% full. And then assembly instructions for the base or the stand. Further instructions are found online at their website, where they have videos showing you how to assemble everything and how to add gas or propane to the tank. But this is a viable and I think a really good solution to those disposable and wasteful tanks. So I'm going to go ahead and hook up the larger propane tank onto this, or set it on here, and hook everything up and then fill this tank and show you how it's done. Alrighty, so this valve is open and we're going to insert this key into the side here. And we will open this up, and when we do, then we'll squeeze this lever, which should transfer propane from the larger tank to this tank. And we should be able to tell when it's 80% full, you'll see a little bit of a little bit of a mist from coming out from that hole on the side here, letting us know that it is 80% full. So I'm going to open this up and then transfer the propane. And so that tank is 80% full, and it was as simple as that, quick and easy. I will likely buy another one of these tanks, just so I'll have a couple of them whenever I go out, and won't have to use this as much. The larger tank I use typically for my propane heater, a large griddle that I have, and I may use it for a hot water on demand system that I've ordered. I'm not sure if I'll be able to use a smaller tank on that. But this I usually use when I set up my single burner stove really quickly in the morning. It's easy to get this out and hook it up to it instead of trying to hook it up to the larger tank. So it's now just a matter of shutting off this valve right here and undoing this, and there will be a little bit of a release of pressure when we undo this. Definitely want to make sure you're doing this outside or outdoors and away from any open flames. So we've got the lid, then we can just put on here a little plastic lid, which is also a nice touch that it's good for carrying or holding, you know, holding on to. And then we just unscrew this. Might just let any pressure that was in here and typically you'll want to wear some safety gear such as some goggles or glasses and some gloves. This gets really cold, so some gloves would also be helpful. Now the little Allen wrench you don't want to lose, so I'll probably put it in a little Ziploc bag and attach it somehow to something, maybe to this, or just keep it all together in the box here. And it's just a matter of taking this off and disassembling this if you don't want to have it out and taking up space, throwing the base and everything else back in the box, and you are good to go. Got a full or 80% full tank. So I definitely recommend this. I think it's a good product. It's good for the environment. You don't have all those extra little 1 pound tanks sitting around or throwing out. And it's a safe way to refill tanks. You know, you don't have to worry about those other tanks that it might, the valve or something might go bad. You can always test these every so often with soap and water to make sure that there are no leaks. But I really like this as an alternative to the disposable 1 pound cylinders.